to video one of your postnatal course. Today we're going to recap on the homework set in Monday's class, which was your pelvic floor exercises, fast and slow contractions, your static contractions, which are for your abdominal muscles, pelvic tilts and plank preparations, both of which are fantastic for rejoining those abdominal muscles if they were to separate during your pregnancy. So the pelvic floor I'm going to do for video purposes sitting here, however you may prefer to do this sitting in a chair, be it a hardback dining chair or just a sofa settee, is absolutely fine. So the slow contractions you're going to start, if you imagine that the pelvic floor is on a lift and it's the ground floor, and you're going to lift the lift up to the 10th floor of the building, so as high as you can lift it, nice and slowly, taking 10 counts. So you breathe into the pair, and as you breathe out, you're going to draw the pelvic floor up as slowly as you can. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then 10 counts back down to the ground floor. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now to begin with, that might be quite difficult to take all 10 counts. Do what you can, as slowly as you can, and just keep practicing. Try and do it once a day, and it's just one lift up and one lift down. The fast contractions are much easier. They just lift up and down, as if you've got a super lift going from the ground floor to the 10th floor in a split second. Up and down, up and down. Now you might find the bottom muscles get involved in this one, that's absolutely fine. You want to lift up and down, up and down. It's the kind of contraction you have if you're trying to stop yourself going to the toilet. Now, the static contractions, they were for the tummy muscles. In class, we did these sitting on a chair with your elbows resting on your knees. Again, for the purposes of the video, I'm going to do this one on all fours. This will also work for you at home, although you might prefer to rest your elbows onto the sofa or a chair. From here, you breathe in and you just let your tummy muscles hang. As you breathe out, you draw the belly button up to the spine, drawing everything in, keeping the shoulders down, and then you breathe in and let everything hang again. You breathe out to draw it back up, and you breathe in to let it all go. Breathe out to draw it back up, and breathe in. Now once you get the hang of this, you can then draw the muscles in, and instead of letting them go on your inward breath, you hold them there, so you breathe in with the tummy muscles held. And you breathe out with the tummy muscles held. Breathe in, and breathe out. The more you can practice this one, the better your tummy muscles are going to get, and the quicker they're going to rejoin back together again. The pelvic tilt muscles, or pelvic tilt exercise, sorry, is done laying on your back. Your feet are hip distance apart, you're laying on your back with your spine in a neutral alignment. So it'll be a natural curve. I don't want your back to be arched here or flattened. You don't want a flat back with your tailbone tucked. You're keeping in a neutral position between those two. Relax the arms on the floor beside you. You breathe into the pair. And as you breathe out, you're going to tuck the tail between the legs, clenching into the bottom muscles and pressing the back into the floor. So your tummy muscles are going to draw down into the mat. You breathe in to come back up to the starting position. Be careful not to arch, just back to neutral. You breathe in, breathe out to tuck. It doesn't have to go too far. Your bottom doesn't need to come off the floor. It stays on the floor and you're just pressing the back. Breathe in to release. Breathe out to tuck. Breathe into your knees. You can do this as many times as you wish, but aim for about 10 in a row before having a little break. And then the last exercise, if you have time to practice, is your plank preparation. You start on your tummy. You have your elbows directly under your shoulders. Your shoulders are pulled down, and the back is just relaxed. This position is very comfortable, and you'll probably find it's forcing you into a position that is rather uncomfortable for your spine. So we're going to come out of that as quickly as we can. Your eyelids sitting down between your hands. You take a breath in. And as you do with the last exercise, you tuck the tail underneath, flattening that back out as much as you can into its neutral spine. You breathe in to come back to neutral. You breathe out to tuck. Breathe into release. Breathe out to tuck. And you can carry it at this pace for as many times as you wish. You're aiming to build up your stamina on this one, so you're going to start trying to hold it for up to about 5 to 10 seconds at a time. And then release it. Your belly button is drawing right into the spine as tightly as you can each time. And then you fully relax at the bottom. Eventually, we're going to be working up to 30 seconds at a time in this held position. You'll probably find the bottom muscles are clenching, actually spine as well. Just draw the shoulders down, don't let them come up around your ears. So there are four exercises for you to practice between now and next week. If you have the time, you can always come back to this video at any point over the six-week course and beyond. So just to recap, you have your pelvic floor fast and slow, 10 counts up, 10 counts down, and your fast ones up and down, up and down. The static contractions are with the tummy breathing into the hand, the pelvic tilts, rocking the pelvis, and the plank preps, pulling the tummy muscles up away from the floor. If you have any questions on any of these exercises, do please give me an email or a call. I'll be happy to help. Otherwise, I'll see you next Monday in class. Thanks ever so much. Bye-bye.